السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. This is your brother Musab ibn Umay, recording for the Prophet's Path channel. Inshallah, today we are going to discuss about inner dimension of fasting. Fasting in the month of Ramadan is a special kind of fasting. Inward requirements for special fasting, this is kind of practice by righteous. It means keeping all one's organs free from sin and some points required for its accomplishment. First point, see not what displeases Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. A chaste regard, restraint from viewing anything that is blameworthy or reprehensible, or that distracts the heart and diverts it from the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, the furtive glance is one of the poisoned arrow of shaitan. Whoever forsakes it for fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will receive from him a fate, the sweetness of which he will find within his heart. Jabir radiallahu ta'ala anhu relates from Anas radiallahu ta'ala anhu that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, five things break a man's fast: lying, backbiting, gossiping, perjury, and the lustful gaze. Another point, speak not what displeases Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Guarding one's tongue from idle chatter, lying, gossiping, obscenity, rudeness, arguing, and controversy, making it absorb silence and occupying it with the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And with recitation of Quran, this is the fasting of tongue. Sufyan al-Thawri rahimahullah said, backbiting annuls the fast. Like quotes Mujahid as saying, two habits annul fasting, backbiting and telling lies. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, fasting is a shield. So when one of you is fasting, he should not use foul or foolish talk. If someone attacks him or insults him, let him say, I am fasting, I am fasting. Another point is, look to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with fear and hope. After the fast has been broken, the heart should swing like a pendulum between fear and hope. For one does not know if one's fast will be accepted, so that one will find favor with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, or whether it will be rejected, leaving ones among those who abhors. This is how one should be at the end of any act of worship one performs. It is related Al-Hasan ibn Abil Hasan al-Basri rahimahullah that he once passed by a group of people who were laughing merrily. He said, Subhanallah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has made the month of Ramadan a race course on which his creatures compete in his worship. Some have come in fast and own, while others have lagged behind and lost. It is absolutely amazing to find anybody laughing and playing about on the day when success attains the victors and failure the worsters. By Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, if the veil were lifted off, the order of good would surely be preoccupied with his good works and the evildoer with his evil deeds. In too full of joy to indulge in idle sports, while for one who has suffered rejection, laughter will be precluded by remorse. Al-Ahnab ibn Qais, it is reported that he was once told, you are an old aged elder, fasting would be enfeeble you. But he replied, by this I am making ready for a long journey. Obedience to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is easier to endure than his punishment. So such are the inwardly significant meaning of fasting. May Allah give us tawfiq to understand. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
الرحمن فيضا من البركات أنجو من النيران ومخاطر الدركات ويرجح الميزان ويرجح الميزان. ويرجح الميزان بجميل الحسنات.